Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now playing version 1.12. Another hot fix just came out. Literally just came out like 40 minutes ago from when I'm speaking right now. Fixes some kind of buffer overrun issue and something about non-ASLR DLL files or something. It's a really small fix. 1.12 here, literally, well, I'm playing this episode right after the previous one in my time. So the update was put in during the episode you saw previously, episode 37. So I found that pretty funny. I went out of the game, you know, I usually quit out and make some notes and then like rename my directory and stuff like that that the video files are put in, and then start fresh, and then it said 1.12 and I'm like, wait a second, when did that come out? And it just came out. Anyway,
damn,
we're gonna
I need more time.
I need more time
on.
Baby, we're going to Lizzie's bar to meet with
Listen,
Judy.
If anything, you can take your shit back and force it on someone else.
Yeah, I gotta go find my way around here. Bump into lots of people, I'm sure. It wants me to... Well, it wants me to go this way, actually. Wait. Oh. 500 meters? I am not buying that. At least not until I have a lot of money. NCPD. Assault in progress. Scan the mural to find a tarot card. That sounds interesting. Weapon I need some ammo, actually. So I might just be sticking around here. I might not be talking to her just yet. What's this? Oh, it's another tarot card. The funny thing is, it says where... It says 500 meters. That's a lot further than 500 meters. Victor's right there. Let's go do this tarot card then. Since it's like right here. Oh, it's you. How you doing? How's things?
How's it going, Misty? You all right?
I think so. Not easy, you know. Putting my life back together. Without him.
Yeah.
And you? I mean, you too?
So you want to say hi?
Chat
about the good old days?
Maybe we're starting to get along. He's driving me crazy.
Johnny. Driving me out of my goddamn mind. Not enough he's whacked wants me to be too.
Sorry to hear that. Hope you two can still figure it out.
Thanks. Did you make up with Mama Wells?
How's it going with Mama Wells?
Pretty good. Maybe too good.
Really?
How's that?
After we said goodbye to Jackie, she invited me over. We talked for a while.
Well, that's nice.
Now, not a day goes by when she doesn't call. Ask how it's going. Tells me about herself, Jackie, everything. Sometimes for hours.
Wow.
Sent me a roast the other day. You believe that? Apparently I'm too skinny. She knows I don't eat meat.
She's adopting you.
I'm afraid she's trying to, I don't know, adopt me somehow.
Exactly. That's exactly what I was thinking. What's wrong with that?
What's the big deal? Wish someone would make me a roast.
I think Miss Wells is using me to avoid thinking about her son's death.
With a new surrogate daughter.
Exactly.
How's business?
How's biz, Misty? Boomin'?
You're the first person to walk in here for 2 days. And 2 days ago, it was a pizza guy. Got lost.
That's not good.
People in this town, they've lost their spiritual connection. But well, you know, I'm here to serve them, not the other way around.
As long as you can pay the rent. Well, I guess that's how you have hours to spend talking with Mrs. Wells there, because, there's utterly nothing going on in here except for lost pizza guys. And even that was 2 days ago. You got these cards from Jackie, right?
Jackie gave you these cards, right? Remember when he asked me to help him pick the right deck?
Mm-hmm. He picked just the thing for me, too. I feel a real connection to this deck. We could lay out a spread for you now, if you like.
Sure, why not?
Yeah, why the hell not?
Focus on the recent past and what you expect in the future. The Wheel of Fortune, reversed. You'll meet some setbacks in the future. Consequences of poor decisions, obviously.
Oops. Obviously, what do you mean by that? There's nothing
there.
Justice
reversed. Be very careful with those you meet. Not all will be worthy of your trust.
That's obvious to me. Your cards are invisible.
The High Priestess. Do not seek simple answers. Be open to your intuition, your subconscious, your dreams.
Mm-hmm.
The moon. In her light, what was once far away and difficult to grasp becomes sharp and clear.
Well, that sounds good. I read my tarot. Is that the same thing?
Wanna read my tarot?
Sure thing.
Is it the same thing over?
The Hermit.
The Hermit.
In solitude, he discovers the truth about himself and the world. From this, he draws strength. His lantern cutting through the darkness. Could be you, or someone who shows you kindness.
Hmm.
But watch out. A reversed Hierophant lurks in the darkness.
Uh-oh.
He brings crisis, both in life and authority. Rebellion and fanaticism. He is a grave threat.
Mm.
A devil reversed. You will find yourself under the influence of powerful people with unclear motives. Be very careful.
Right. Powerful people.
The tower. You and everyone around you will experience a great shock. When the tower falls, nothing will be the same again. Nothing at all.
Oh, jeez. Thanks for the warning.
Thanks for the up, Miss.
Ooh.
Oh, watch out.
I'm glad you understand.
If you guys heard that, the audio was cutting out a little bit. I was supposed to scan a card, though, wasn't I? I guess that's complete. Alright. Oh, the card's here. Wait a second. What's Bradbury and Baran? Scan the mural. Okay. So I'm here. That wasn't the tarot card thing. I go out the shop and... or through. I go back. I go back here and through. In here? Wait. You want the roof? A mural on the roof? Maybe? Does it say it's down now? No, it kind of looks like it's up. I don't think I've been to this roof. I've been to the roof of Afterlife, but I don't think I've been to this one.
Hey, look!
Whoa!
Would you look at that? You see it too, right?
Either gone completely whacked or I'm having a mystical moment.
What's that chick's name? The one with the hair?
Misty? More likely a neuron misfire for Victor to check out. Or maybe ask them both.
Resembles a major arcana tarot card. The world. Did I do it? Did I scan it? Did I scan it right? Is that it? Alright. I guess that's it. And just like that, he disappears. Because he's only in my head. We got wontons. Bubblegum. Because I was all out of bubblegum. That vinyl record I could pick up. There's a lot of stuff up here. The Solo's Manual by Morgan Blackhand. Okay, I've got that list. Oh, we got another Beelzebub? So I saw someone standing there. Alright, since we're just hanging out, I'll read this stuff now. The Solo's Manual by Morgan Blackhand. Intro. Think you got what it takes to be a legendary solo, huh? Sure you do. Otherwise, why pick up this book? You're looking for respect, for fear, for a way to be on top. Maybe you heard someone quote me about winning battles with only a glance before a single shot's been fired. Well, fine, I'll let you in on the secret. It is possible, and you can do it too, but only if you got the guts to survive going to hell and back more times than you can count. Thousands of fights, millions of bullets, hundreds of gallons of blood, yours included. That's what you have to look forward to, and you'll need a solid ripper, one you can trust. One you make a lifelong chumbadas out of. One who tells you every week it's a miracle you ain't dead by now. At least that's what he'll say if you're lucky. Nowadays, every kid with a big iron, a sin leather coat, and a micro-missile launcher thinks they're a hotshot solo. But you know what? Just because you killed a few goons with a smile on your lips don't make you one. Anyone can kill. I knew this rocker boy once who blew up a whole platoon of corpo trash. Did that make him a solo? No. It made him dead. So, still think what you got to take to carve your name into solo history? Good. Then this book's for you. I don't know if I read that one before. And Beelzebub. That does not sound familiar. So, wait. How do I get shards? I wish I could look at them all in one. Like, sort them just all of them alphabetically. Otherwise, I'm just looking at them all or trying to figure out. That's the one I picked up. I'm pretty sure I haven't read any Beelzebub. That's a pretty memorable title. Beelzebub's Tales to His Grandson. And then we'll continue on. Even before our arrival, many beings in Babylon had lost their minds over this subject, while many others were inching closer to the same fate. The burning question of the day, the question that racked the brains of both pitiful scientists and normal beings of Babylon, was this: do we have a soul or not? There were all sorts of the most fantastic theories on this subject, with new ones appearing all the time, and each and every one of the tempting hypotheses had its supporters. Despite the overwhelming number and diversity of these beliefs, they were all based on one of two completely opposing premises. The first was called atheism, while the other was idealism or dualism. Dualism? All dualistic hypotheses held the soul existed. I lost my place. Existed, and of course that it was immortal and could suffer many things even after the death of the being. Meanwhile, the atheistic theories held the complete opposite view. In short, my boy, when we came to Babylon, we came upon what could be only could only be called constructing the Tower of Babel. I thought that was going to be more entertaining. Tales to Your Grandson. That was going to be like a short stories or something, or parables of evilness. Yeah, I definitely had not been to that roof. It gets screwed up. It thinks it's up when we're going down. Like, no, it's further down. That's Victor. We don't need to see Victor right now. Though I love him dearly, and I hope to eventually pay him back for his 21,000 eddies. Oh, do I have to go that way? No. I saw a weird image in town.
Saw a weird image out on the street.
Oh.
Seems like your line of work.
On the roof, actually.
What'd it look like?
Grabbed a scan, take a look.
Tarot. Major Arcanum. What you saw was a sign from a higher power.
Really? Major Arcanum, what's that?
The what now? Major Arcanum?
Tarot card, archetype, knowledge held in symbolic form, a stage in your journey through life. Take your pick.
Okay.
Either way, you're saying some higher power's talking to me through tarot cards?
Or to Silverhand. Or both of you, seeing as you form a harmonious whole at the moment.
Oh yeah, harmonious. and as higher power can be a little clearer.
Be a little easier if this higher power learned to be direct.
Well, the world is a maze of illusions. It's not easy for the light to shine into the prison of our earthly existence.
Right, great. So, what do I do with a sign I can't understand from a power I know nothing about?
Needs to be interpreted.
I'd start by looking for more of them. The tarot describes a road, so go down it.
What do I do with what I find?
Still don't know what I'm supposed to do with what I find.
Look for more images. They must have some connection to the place where you find them. Think about what you see. You ask me? They've been sent to help you find the truth.
Oh, finding the truth is pretty far down on my list at the moment.
A difficult time is coming when you'll have to choose which road to take. Then, you'll understand.
Dunno.
Come on back when you've found more. I'll help you decipher what you've seen.
Okay. Fool on a hill. Find all the tarot graffiti in the city. Talk to Victor? Maybe these strange images that you're seeing really do exist. Or maybe the biochips already turned your brain into scop and salmon casserole. Whatever the case, spotting these images in unexpected places feels like a mystery begging to be solved. In your shoes, I'd have a word with Victor or that chakra chick about these. Should interest at least one of them. Well, we're right here. Let's go talk to Victor. Nothing else to say. Alright. I'll take that. I forget, is he down or is he in here?
Oh, leave me alone.
I'll jump right on you. Hey, Victor. I saw a weird mural on the wall.
Listen, don't laugh, but I've been seeing some weird shit around town. Like, murals or something. But no, they're not real.
Just a Kuroshi blip. Could take a look.
Oh, no. Really?
No, images are too complex for a blip. It's like they're symbols.
That case is the biochip. Brain can't handle the data overload. Either that, or it's reached the cortex.
Can you do anything?
Nope. Better find a way to get rid of that chip.
Wow. In any case, can I talk to him about the... Can I talk to you? I can't talk to you. Come on, you have a thing over your head. I want to talk to him more about the chip. Just try to go out and come back, maybe. Okay, let's talk Johnny and the chip. That's what I wanted to do.
Got a few questions about Silverhand and this chip.
I'm no expert, but fire away. See what I can do.
Why can I see him?
How is it even possible, seeing him?
Well, that biochip is designed for users to communicate with constructs. It's just doing its job.
Okay. So I got Arasaka to thank.
You know, I wager you have the lowest net worth of any relic owner out there.
Why am I seeing his memories?
Why am I reliving Johnny's memories?
You two share a brain now.
True.
He has access to your senses, perceptions, even some memories. Likewise, you've got a glimpse into his. After a while, won't even know whose is whose.
Well, I like that. I'm used to exiting out to stop exit conversation. I wanted to ask him one more thing, though. What if he tries to kill me? Never mind. Alright, so 1 out of 20. We need to find 19 more of these things. That's Kabuki. I'm not doing the high ones yet. Makes sense to tackle the moderate stuff. Try talking to... Oh, that's back by my house. I need to pay him off, yeah, someday. Well, we're gonna talk to Judy, right? I'm gonna talk to Judy, yeah. Just making sure nothing else to say.
And I tell you, no! Arasakas are no ordinary clan.
500 meters, it lies. Is that miles? Or meters? That's meters? That looks a lot further than... Well, there's a side job here. I might as well do the stuff that's near me. Bradbury and... What's Bradbury and Brad? Is that a quest? Wait. Yeah, I don't know what that is, Bradbury and Baran, but let's do the side job thingy. Unless it's the same one I just did. It's...
Their bodies, they never age!
Oh, you?
But notice their eyes, cold and dead! Their corporation exists only as cover for their wicked means to live, or rather, to remain undead. I tell you now, Saburo is not gone from our world. He rests undisturbed in the family crypt.
Bum.
He feasts on the blood of his servants, awaiting his body's rejuvenation. To return once more. Mark my words!
Saburo's dead.
Right, so Saburo is definitely dead. Like, trust me on this.
Saw it happen.
Such conviction! You witnessed his death with your own eyes?
Exactly.
Well, it just so happens I've... No, no, I did not.
Yeah, we don't want to reveal that.
You see? You see? But how could mere mortals become these death-defying abominations, you ask? With the help of techno-necromancers from Alpha Centauri! It was their tainted blood Saburo Arasaka drank to transform himself into this devil spawn!
Gary, what? You can't spill Arasaka's secrets! They gon' find you!
Let them! The seed has been sown! The truth shall sprout roots and lift us from the invader's clutches!
Is he gonna be in
Radio
trouble?
Radio waves bear the truth! Let those with ears listen and those with eyes bubble!
Is something gonna happen here? We're just...
I recognize you. You come here often. Your eyes tell me that your mind has opened to the truth.
Really?
Will you provide a humble donation so that I may continue my mission?
€1 or 100? I wish there was something in between. Oh, I got the money right now. I know I'm supposed to be saving it for Victor, but yeah, I'll do better than humble.
You do good work. Use this to wake Night City up.
Thank you for your devotion. I saw a disciple of truth in you from the very beginning.
You're welcome.
Their mothership conceals itself above our very heads. Ready yourself, for they are coming!
Alright, so it's gone. Assault in progress. There's another mural here. Drop point. Not buying a vehicle. I can't track that. Was it zoom in? Alright. Well, I can track that. I'll start by my apartment. What's Bradbury? I'm really curious about that. What is Bradbury and Baran? Just like a shop? This? Oh, it's a drop. It's a fast travel thing. Not a drop point. Oh. So, wait, there's a tarot card right there. Yes. It's gonna take me a long time to get. Any missions with all these tarot cards and side jobs and assault in progress stuff. Let me explain. Ouch. Interesting. Johnny gonna show up again? Scan.
We got a problem?
Resembles a major arcana tarot card, the Chariot. Are you okay over there?
You don't wanna fuck with me!
Not generally, no. Alright. Don't lay on the ground in front of murals, then. They hit the kid. I didn't mean they hit the kid.
Those eddies were to get us the fuck out of here!
You know how best plans go awry. that? Racketeer Tiger Claws. They're unarmed, though. What does one do? Trespassing in a corporate zone. Blackmail of a corporate rep. Vandalism. Kidnapping for ransom. There's a tarot card there. Wait a second. Drop point. I don't think I'll hit that yet. That might be on the roof of, I have a feeling it may or may not be. Yeah, it's like, it looks like it's inside Afterlife or on the roof, so I'm not gonna go there yet. Because that's a high, dangerous thingy. Try talking to Barry. What's your deal? No deal, Sporto. How far away? That beat.
And fuck you!
Same to you and the horse you rode in on. I did that one.
Lawrence?
Would you call me Lawrence? Well, I'm not going the right way. So to go through here then? Yeah.
Can't do nothing.
Is it that far? Probably easier and just to run over there. Maybe. People off in space in such a manner that you just have to bump into them. There's no other way. Ooh, was that guy young? Alright, so now we go up? I might buy my apartment now. The mural is upstairs, maybe? I'll check on Gary and do the mural thing. Disabled. Stuff's falling. Oh, I said disabled, it's working.
Welcome to N54 News. I'm Jillian Jordan. We begin now with your latest local news. The 54th anniversary of the AHQ disaster is fast approaching. In 2023, Night City was shaken to its core by the detonation of a tactical nuclear bomb in Arasaka's NC headquarters. 12,000 were killed instantly by the blast, and thousands more later succumbed to acute radiation sickness.
It looks like I'm still headed the right way. Tracking the mural, 40 meters. Hey, Barry!
Barry? Am I remembering that right?
Who is it?
V! Your neighbor from upstairs. Remember me? Talked about Prime Rides. Back then, you were pumped about the Mizutani Shion. I said it was for flash posers.
You don't forget a gonk thing like that.
He gave me this look. I was about to hightail it to the Badlands right then and there.
Oh, you remember.
The infamous,
what do you want?
The infamous Barry. I just want to talk.
Just want to talk, that's all. I know it's what you need right now, even if you don't want to admit it. I can't turn back time for you, but I can sit next to you and listen. Remind you that you're not in this alone.
Now, hold on a sec. We barely know each other, and you just rock up here talking to me about my problems.
Someone's gotta.
Where'd you get the idea something with me was up? You watching me? Someone send you?
Your friends asked me to drop by.
All right, you got me. Your friends asked me to drop in on you, so I thought, hey, why not? He's a stand-up guy. Who cares if he has shitty taste when it comes to street shredders?
Come back just to get your ass kicked?
Yeah.
Man, you really know how to cheer a guy up. Maybe those two asshats really are worried about me.
All right, come on in. Talk, so... let's talk.
Spiderweb tattoo, I like it.